And a tremendous force at the plate. We'll get to see that big bat of Edwin Encarnacion. Defending the home field advantage today in Toronto, it's the Blue Jays. I'm Gary Thorne, along with Steve Phillips and John Krakauer, an analyst, and we are ready to go. 2K Sports MLB. And let's glance at Toronto's starter. Steve will be watching how he approaches this Cleveland lineup.
I've got a good right-hander on the mound and a good lineup that he's facing right here. And it's going to come down to execution on either side to see who prevails.
Get a moment to check out that lineup for the Indians. Scouting pick, John, who are we looking at today?
Well, Carlos Santana is a once-in-a-lifetime player. Great catcher, great arm, but he can also hit for power. When's he going to reach that potential? Maybe this year.
First pitch of the game will be to Michael Brantley. Well, loss last night for the Indians. Not a good run for them right now. They've dropped their last four.
Well, and this team is just going to have to start making a little bit of adjustments. First two games are 0-2. These guys should have come out of spring training firing on all cylinders.
This game underway, count 1-0. And you can bet they're hungry, even though it's early, to get that first win.
Yeah, it definitely is, and that's the thing. You don't want to extend this thing to three games losing streak. You want to take care of business and get it done early.
Here's the pitch. And here's a swing and a miss. He couldn't get that one. 1-2.
The trend for him is not very good right now, as he's just one for his last seven at-bats.
And he knows with his name at the top of the order that he has to do a better job than that.
2-2. Michael Brantley watches that one go by. That'll even up the count.
Well, that two-seam fastball has to be thrown down in the zone. You throw it up, it flattens out, and you can get hurt.
2-2. Curve that misses. 3-2.
He's dragging his arm on his curveball, and the ball just hanging up in the zone. He's got to pull it through.
Here's the payoff pitch. Line drive. That's foul towards first. Full count pitch. And it's fouled away.
Well, this is something you work on every once in a while in batting practice, that defensive approach. You just try to see it and try to put it in play. And a lot of times you just try to foul off a pitch that you know you can't handle just to keep the at-bat alive. That's what he did right here. Practice paid off.
Rung him up. Strike three. Count that one as K.
He pulled the string right there. Must have been looking for the fastball. Swings right through the changeup for strike three.
And we've got Kipnis here. Big problem for the Blue Jays pitching staff last year, free passes. Way too many of them that got them in jams, putting runners on base. Fastball, swung on and missed, 0-1. Talking about the Blue Jays, when you lead the league in walks as a staff, you're making things really tough on yourself, Steve.
Well, especially in the American League East, when you have so many teams that can hit the ball in the ballpark. You put runners on with a base on ball, you're just adding to the pain you can suffer. They need to throw the ball more over the plate.
Pitch on the way.
You're out.
Swing and a miss. Strike three. Jason Kipnis is gone.
Well, just a great sequence of pitches. Three good choices by the pitcher and the catcher, and he finishes them off quickly.
All pitchers love that. Those are short at-bats. You get it done in a hurry. Nick Swisher. The career batting average for him, .242 against the Blue Jays.
Foul ball.
Hit foul by Swisher. Here's the pitch.
Foul!
Swisher with a foul ball again.
Ball!
Fastball is up high, and it's 1-2.
Let's see if he bounces back after last night's game, striking out twice. See if he has a little bit more plate discipline.
The 1-2 on its way.
You're out!
Strike three, swung on and missed. Nick Swisher, no luck. It's the kind of inning the defense likes. Three up, three down. So it'll be the Toronto Blue Jays, bottom half of the first. Ubaldo Jimenez is going to be pitching. Cleveland's got him starting in this one. Steve, he's facing that Toronto lineup today. What is he thinking about?
Well, Ubaldo Jimenez does not have the same kind of velocity on his fastball that he once did. And that means he better locate the fastball a little bit more. Now he has a quirky delivery, which at times is difficult to repeat, and therefore is at times difficult to throw strikes. He has to locate the fastball for a strike if he's going to be successful.
The 1-1. A swing line to left center. And the leadoff bat of this ball game's on board. Let's see if they get it started early. We'll take a moment to look at the Blue Jays lineup. And our scouting report, John, who are we watching for today?
Well, I love when guys finally put it together and figured out, and Edwin Encarnacion figured it out in 2012, one of the top power hitters in the game.
Now we'll take a quick look at the Indians, how they line up in the field. Any picks, John?
Well, he was viewed as an outfielder at one point in his career, but Jason Kipnis right now has established himself as a good second baseman in major leagues. Solid defender, makes the routine plays, and every once in a while, he'll come up with some special ones.
The pitch from Jimenez.
Ball!
Just off the outside, and it's 1-0.
Hey, check out Donaldson. The bat's been talking for him lately. 4 for his last 7. If you want to score runs, you need men on base, and that's exactly what he's been doing. High rate of success getting himself on base.
Ball two.
Let's take it outside for a ball two. 1 strike count. And Josh Donaldson works this one to the hitters, count 3-1.
Coming off a good ball game last night, picking up 2 hits in that one.
There's a swing and a smash. This one's towards Brantley. And he grabs it in his tracks. And a look at next Sunday. It'll be the Washington Nationals playing on the road. They head into Great American Ballpark to take on the Reds. That will kick off at 1 p.m. Eastern.
Okay, that's going to be a great matchup, and everybody's going to want to tune into that one. I'm looking forward to it.
And Jose Bautista at the plate, a runner on first. Jose Bautista has arguably been the best source of power in the majors over the last few years. 54 homers in 2010, 43 and 11. 27 was leading the way last year when he got injured. Pauses, and now the 1-0. There's contact. He drove it well. This one's towards Brantley. Out number two. And they'll hold him at first base. Here's Edwin Encarnacion with 2 down. Last year, he picked up 6 hits and 25 at-bats against the Indians. The pitch from Jimenez.
Strike one!
It's now 0-1. Watch that fastball go by.
The location and velocity are critical in throwing the fastball. He runs his good fastball up and away right here, and it's a take pitch.
And a ground ball to Chisenhall. Throws on to first in time to retire the side. And a good inning. Ubaldo Jimenez works his way out of the first inning without allowing anyone to score. And we'll see the Indians next. Big bats ready to make an appearance. And if you just joined our broadcast, great to have you on board. 2K Sports Major League Baseball. I'm Gary Thorne with Steve Phillips and John Crump. And Mark Reynolds. Fastball in there, 0-1.
Outstanding mechanics right there. He gets all of his body into the pitch. Great velocity on it. A strike away.
The pitch.
Strike two.
Off-speed pitch is in there, and he falls behind, 0-2. That's it, foul by Reynolds. Fastball swung out and missed, struck him out, one away.
A good break on a 90-mile-an-hour pitch.
Well, back-to-back pitches, they just did the job beautifully.
John, I think those last fastballs actually threw off his timing. He looked like he might have been looking for something else.
Yeah, that's a difficult part of hitting. If you're looking for a breaking ball and you get a fastball, it can make you look bad.
And it's Chisenhall at the plate.
Yeah.
Ball.
That misses inside, 1-0.
A front door two-seam fastball trying to throw it inside, letting it tail back to the inside corner. Couldn't quite catch the corner, though.
1-0 on the way.
Ball two.
Fastball just misses, and he falls behind 2-0. Good pitch that time. That had him out in front of it, and it's 2-1.
Well, climbing the ladder at him right there. He just throws that fastball right by him up in the zone.
Here's the 2-1 pitch.
Strike two.
Swing and a miss. Lonnie Chisenhall not making contact there to even up the count.
Well, a lot of times movement will fool a hitter, but it looked like right here the velocity on that pitch was what caused him to swing and miss and be late.
Ball.
And that's just high for a ball. Runs the count. 3-2.
You're playing with fire right there. Handing the breaking ball up in the zone. That's the way you can get hurt.
3-2 on the way.
You're out.
Big swing and a miss for Lonnie Chisenhall. Strike three, and he is gone. Well, at least he's wearing out the pitcher a little bit on that event.
That's one way to look at it.
Well, a look here at last year in the American League and where the Indians ranked compared to everybody else. 7th in stolen bases, 9th in batting average, and they were in the top 10 in hits, a lineup that was able to make a lot of contact and put the ball in play.
Here's the delivery.
Ball one.
Change up just misses. 1-0. 1 for 12 last season against the Blue Jays here in Toronto. Now the 1-0 pitch.
Strike one.
And Asdrubal Cabrera with a swing and a miss for a strike and an even count.
He has that little running action on that two-seam fastball that busts in on the hands of the hitter. It's a tough pitch. Now they have a chance to go to the outer part of the plate.
Ball.
Good-looking fastball. Called the ball, though, 2-1.
Well, let's just see what he comes back with right there. He wanted that pitch. He didn't get it. Now he has to refocus and throw another one.
2-1 pitch, a changeup swung on and missed. 2-2.
Boy, he just couldn't wait for that changeup to get in the strike zone. You can't try to chase it. You have to let it come to you.
Now the 2-2.
Foul!
That one goes foul.
Ball!
Fastball well off the mark, and it's full 3-2. And, you know, any great pitching coach will emphasize the importance of mixing up your pitch types. Let's see how this guy's been doing in that regard.
Well, the one thing I think compared to what...
Hit in the air to center field. Base hit. Gets it down. That's our first hit of the game for these guys. And that'll bring up Carlos Santana.
Well, you wonder he had the energy to run to first base after seeing that many pitches, fouling off pitches, taking tough pitches. But he did. Well, thank goodness he only had to run 90 feet because I'd imagine he was pretty tired.
Top five last season in walks.
Ball.
Can't get him to chase that one outside. Ball one.
Right.
Gets
one.
That call at the knees. Evens the count at one apiece. He had a 5-for-20 last year off the Blue Jays. The pitch. There's a swing, and that one's hit on the ground.
Yeah.
Throw on to second base. Forced play. Side retired. And Marco Estrada heads in. Good start for him. And it'll be the Blue Jays coming right up. And welcome to those of you just tuning in. 2K Sports, Major League Baseball. This is Gary Thorne along with Steve Phillips and John Crook. And it's Russell Martin. He'll start the home half of the second. Fouled off. Here's the 0-1 pitch from Jimenez. Good eye by Russell Martin. Stays away and it's even. Last season, an 0-for-3 against Gibaldo Jimenez. Martin grounds it. Chisholm all the dive, and he's up with it. Throws in time to first. What a play. You knew we were going to say hot corner on this play, Steve.
There's no question about it. You've got to be scared sometimes down there with the way the ball gets on you. Great reactions, and then the accurate throw from his knee.
And it's Troy Tulowitzki now.
The lumber's been real active right now, making good contact. He's got four for his last eight.
And the manager has to be tickled to death to have a guy that's always on base for the guys behind him.
Hit up the middle. And Tulowitzki's got a single. And that's going to bring B.J. Upton to the plate.
I've got a moment to take a look back to last year's Toronto Blue Jays. Fifth in home runs, fifth in stolen bases. And they were in the top 10 in runs, an offense that was relentless, that ability to continue to put the pressure on the opposition and take pressure off their own pitching staff.
It hasn't been easy for Yubaldo Jimenez since he left Colorado. He got roughed up again last year, posted a career high, worse across the board.
Strike
the fastball is in there. It's 0-1. Those career high worse, Jimenez, 540 ERA, a 1.61 whip. Control an issue for him, just could not find a way to get hitters off speed.
And I think the most alarming fact is fastball velocity is down. Here's a guy who used to throw in the high 90s, and he used to run that fastball by hitters, not getting away with that anymore.
Foul!
It's hit foul by Upton.
Ball.
Fastball is a waste pitch that time, 1-2. Here's the delivery.
Oh!
And Upton fights off another.
Well, anytime you're behind in a count, and in this case the 1-2 count, you have to maintain that focus. You have to really be dialed into what the pitcher's throwing. You have to get in that defensive mode, though, and make sure you can foul it off. And that's what he did there to keep himself going.
Toronto, here's a position to get something done.
Well, you would like to see him done it on the first pitch, get that base hit. But if it took a while, it doesn't matter if you're the hitter. As long as that base hit gets put in the column, he is rewarded, and he deserves it.
Ball one.
First pitch inside, ball one.
Strike one.
Let's the 1-0 pitch go by, 1-1. Now the 1-1 pitch.
Foul!
Swung on and fouled away. 1-2 pitch coming. Swung on, hit in the air to right center. Two men have been put away. Take a look at the teams who led in stolen bases last year. Number one, the Twins. Second, the Angels. The Rays, third. Fourth spot held with the Royals. And for the Blue Jays, they are in fifth.
Well, most teams have one guy who can steal bases. This team has a bunch of guys who can run. Last year, one of the top teams in the league at stealing bases. And you think, well, we got one base stealer out. Well, as soon as he gets out, here comes another. Seems like every time someone's on base, they have the ability to steal bases. Way too much pressure for the opposition.
1-1.
He watches one miss low and outside. 1-1.
Well, he wanted to just tag the outside corner with that slider, but just off the plate for a ball.
Comes set, now the 1-1. Swing and a high pop-up left side of the infield. This one's going to be fielded by Kipnis. That one's grabbed, side retired. So, no runs, two hits, and they strand two. Both teams still looking for that first run here in Toronto. We've got Neil in the box. He'll start things off here in the third inning. Here's the pitch.
Strike
chases
one.
That first pitch. Starts off with a strike.
That two-seam fastball away is just screaming to be hit on the ground as the hitter opens up. Awfully tough to hit with that kind of movement.
The pitch.
Ball one.
That one is going to miss. Low for a ball. 1-1.
Ball.
1-1 pitch, fastball, high, 2-1. A 2-1 pitch. A swing and a fly ball to left center field. And it's caught. Play made by Saunders. That's one away.
Well, this ball is headed to the gap, but the left fielder got a good jump on it, able to run it down and make the play.
One away, and here's Rajah Davis. He hit 258 last season against the Blue Jays here in Toronto. Swings and grounds this one foul, wide of third. Davis again fouling it off. Oh, tough one to lay off right there, that fastball. One and two.
Well, Estrada has really shown us how it's done.
Well, it's truly been a tremendous day on the mound for this man. Here's a breakdown of how he's been mixing up his locations, using that to his advantage.
You know, we've seen him move the ball around effectively in the strike zone. That unpredictability is keeping the hitters off balance.
And no doubt, Steve, he's gone inside, outside, high and low. This is the kind of game he wanted to come and pitch today.
Fouled away. Now Martin positions himself. Hit sharply down the line. And Donaldson gloves that one. And a chance now to check out the schedule for Toronto. Tonight's game, the last against Cleveland. Then they have a home field advantage. They'll take on the Red Sox in the bat of Jacoby Ellsbury. A great series there. That's a three-game series. Following that, they'll be on the road to play the Tigers and one of the game's best hitters, Miguel Cabrera. A team that will definitely give them a competitive series. Here's Michael Brantley now with two away. First pitch to him. First pitch, a fastball. That's in there for a strike. He deals. Michael Brantley watches that one go by. That'll even up the count.
He went with the big curveball off the plate, trying to get him to reach for it, but he lays off.
That's a foul ball. The 1-2 pitch.
You're
out. That one sails by Michael Brantley. Got him napping. That's right. No scoring here, ending this half inning. Been about the defense, not the offense. Here at Rogers Center at score. The skipper that's happy not to have given up any runs yet, but watching for that opportunity for his offense to get on the board. And it's 0-1. Jimenez gets him looking. And a moment here to see how this pitcher has been mixing up his pitches.
Yeah, and a couple times he's gotten a little bit out of rhythm, got a few hiccups here and there, but for the most part, he's been pretty outstanding.
Well, some of the hitters have been able to put the ball in play and hit the ball hard, but it's not about mixing his pitches up. He's got to execute the pitch when he throws it as well.
This with the fastball outside, 2-1. Here's the delivery.
Ball!
That's off the plate away, 3-1.
Well, this is your dream when you're in the on-deck circle before you go into the batter's box. If you can get the count to 3-1 and in your favor, you know you have the upper hand.
Swings, hits this one pretty well, deep right center. He gets over to it. Still settling into the season. Here's who the Indians are going to be facing. Tonight's game, the last against Toronto. After that, the always tough Rays. They'll face them on the road with Ben Zobrist in the Rays lineup. That's Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And then they'll have to contend with Derek Jeter as they play host to the Yankees. Not too tough a schedule coming up for them. Now batting with one down, Josh Donaldson. Here's the first pitch. Towards the middle. And that's a base hit. Donaldson on. That will bring up Jose Bautista.
Well, he waited for that one to get deep in the zone, and he put a good swing on it. Now with one out, let's see if they try to move him along.
Last time up, flew up. The first pitch, swung on and ripped toward second. One decides not to try for the double play, hangs onto it. And with this break in the action, let's take a look at the players with the RBI lead last year in the league. There you see Encarnacion. He shows up third.
Well, there's reasons why guys hit in certain spots of the batting order, because the middle of the order guys are run producers. And that's what he is, one of the best in baseball last year. And he continues to drive in runs. That's why he hits where he is and why he's such a vital part to this team's success.
Slider's in there for a called strike. Just a 1-for-5 last year against Gibaldo Jimenez. Oh, what a drive. He smashed it. This one's towards Brantley. And that's out number 3. No runs on a base hit. They leave one man on at first. Both teams still looking for that first run here in Toronto. Leadoff hitter Jason Kipnis. Right now in the night, 0-for-1 against Estrada.
Well, that last time up, he struck him out on the two-seam fastball. I bet we see that pitch again.
Well, that's the third guy he's put down on strikes when he's used that pitch in a two-strike situation.
He delivers.
Ball!
And Jason Kipnis looks at that one. It is a ball. The count is even.
Well, Gary, they really can't seem to mount any offense at all. I mean, one hit through 4 innings, and you know, you really have to look at your approach at the plate.
And that swung on. That one's hit, and Bautista catches made.
They had him play perfectly. You pitch to your defense. They hit the right spot with the pitcher, and the outfielder was where he should be. They make the out.
The Nick Swisher will dig in here with one away. The Nick Swisher has been a producer. Maybe not the biggest name, but he gets it done. Here it comes.
Ball
way
one.
Out there with the curveball, 1-0. We're talking about Nick Swisher. He's really a player you want in your lineup. He sees a lot of pitches, a lot of walks, great on-base percentage. Big reason sometimes his bat is so important. He swings, hits a ball to right field. 2 away.
He's really on a nice roll right now. Pitching very well. Retired 6 guys in a row.
And Mark Reynolds will stand in with 2 down. Looking back to last season, it was a 259 average against the Jays. And here's the first one.
Foul!
And it's hit foul by Reynolds. Swing and a drive, deep left center. And there's the third out. And a quick inning for Marco Estrada. Well, he's displaying the mastery of the mound right now. That's the story on both sides here. And it'll be the Blue Jays coming right up. He's watched some great deliveries on the mound. Struggling bats, though. Important now to get the offense stinging. And it's Russell Martin. 0-for-1 thus far. That one's wide as Jimenez misses. We have seen a great pitching performance on the mound and a tremendous use of that strike zone that's been on display here.
Pretty impressive stuff, the way he's been pounding this strike zone. It's an indication of the performance we're seeing from him. You don't have success without good use of mixing locations.
You know, John, I agree. I think that he's kept hitters off balance. Every once in a while, I don't like the pitch selection, but he's executed that pitch even when it was the wrong one.
Now the 2-1 pitch.
Strike 2.
Fastball called strike 2.
Well, the hitter lays off this one and takes the strike, realizing not a pitch he wants in this situation.
And here's the pitch.
Foul!
And it goes foul.
Foul ball!
And Martin fights off yet another here in this at bat.
Well, you know he wanted to finish him off right there. But I tell you what, that defensive approach, keeping this at-bat alive, could pay off down the road.
3 and 2.
Second for a ball. Bottom dropped out of that pitch on Jimenez.
Well, a lot of guys would swing at that pitch right there, that changeup down in the strike zone, but the hitter luckily stayed off that one.
There's a swing and a smash. This one's towards Brantley. Didn't have a problem getting over there in time. And Troy Tulowitzki, he'll dig in with one away. Got things going earlier on. First at bat, he got a single off Jimenez.
Well, he's going to definitely be able to approach this at bat with a plan and some confidence. Got a hit on the fastball earlier, so you know he must be able to look for it again.
Called strike, outer half of the plate, 0-1. Now, let's take a moment here to see the breakdown of the pitches that have yielded hits.
Well, guys, you look at that four-seamer. It's been hit two times.
Well, you know, that pitch, even though it's been hit a couple of times, at this point in the game, he's still got a shutout going, so not a lot of weakness to point to. He's getting out of the innings unscathed. Defense is getting the job done behind him.
Back up the middle. Reaction time critical on this play if you're going to get it in the air.
You're not going to see many plays better than this one. The instant it leaves the bat, he reacts quickly and reaches out and makes the catch.
And the lineups with the most home runs around the league last year, number one, the Yankees. The Orioles second, White Sox third, fourth spot, Rangers, and for the Blue Jays, they are in fifth.
Well, this team lives and die with the home run ball. They were one of the top teams in the league last year at hitting the ball out of the ballpark, and they seem to want to continue that in this season. They have so much power and depth throughout this lineup that every one of these guys can hurt you.
He waited on that first pitch and took it. It's 1-0.
Well, he really wanted that one, a fastball just below the knees, and he didn't get the call.
Low for a ball, and it's 2-0. Now the 2-0 pitch. That one swung on and hit. Brantley's going to play it, and that's going to do it in this half inning. No runs, no hits. Nobody crossed the plate in this half inning, and nobody left on base. Both teams still looking for that first run here in Toronto. 5-6-7 hitters to get things started. And it's Lonnie Chisenhall now to lead it off. How's he attacking on the first delivery? Let's look here.
Well, what does an 0-1 count do for you? Well, in this game, it does a lot. He's gotten seven hitters out in this game when he's gone 0-1 in the count. So first pitch strikes me a lot.
Here's the pitch. He makes contact, line drive. And it's through. That'll be a base hit for Chisenhall. So Asdrubal Cabrera will come up.
Great approach at the plate. A great swing, too. I mean, that's just one of those balls that he wasn't trying to do too much. I'm just going to get on base because there's no outs. Now the guys behind me can drive me in.
He singled in his last at bat. And the first pitch.
Strike one!
Swings and misses the slider. 0-1. So far in this one, 1-for-1 off the strata.
You know, he might want to go to the four-seam fastball again, but after the hit he gave up the last time, you may want to wait till the right time in the count to go there.
Well, no runs driven in on the single he had last time up, but he has a chance to drive one in here if he can get one down the line or in a gap.
Ball one!
Fastball is up high, then it's 1-2. One, two pitch coming. Off the ground, played by Donaldson. Over to second for one. And there's two, and Encarnacion wrapping up the double play. Always looking for that friend of a pitcher. They wanted their ground ball and got it.
Now he threw it around the horn to get the double play. Nice turn by the second baseman.
It's Carlos Santana at the plate, two down. Boy, did he draw a lot of walks last year in the AL. And the first pitch. That swung on, hit on the ground. Number 29. He'll throw on to first, and that'll do it for this half inning. Well, that was a quick inning right there, 7-50. No production yet from Cleveland. It's going to be Saunders. Nunes misses for a ball. He swings and drives this one. So Saunders is retired. One away.
Good pitch right there. Got the hitter a little bit out on his front foot. Easy fly ball to center field.
Now their center fielder at the plate. Popped up his last at bat. Here's the first pitch.
Strike one.
And it's 0-1. Jimenez gets him looking.
Now that he's established the strike zone down and in, he can elevate a pitch or go with something soft away from the hitter.
Ball.
Oh, and he lays off the fastball. Good pitch, 1-1. The pitch, hit on the ground, over to shortstop. And Cabrera picks it up. On to first, that's out number two.
Shortstop makes a nice play right here, Gary. Good feet at that position. Gets the easy out at first.
Up now, their second baseman. 1-for-2 in the ballgame. And he throws the first one.
Strike one!
Watches Jimenez's pitch go by.
Great action on that breaking ball. Down in the zone, trying to get the hitter to hit the top of the ball.
One and
tries
one.
Tries a curveball, but it misses. 1-1. The 1-1. A swing and a foul off to the right side. Tried to get him to chase the fastball away, 2-2. This one's bounced up the middle, and Cabrera picks it up. Throws to first in time, that's three down. Three up, three down this half inning. Been about the defense, not the offense, here at Rogers Center. He's got to be really pleased with the pitching, but offensively, his club is struggling. They just can't seem to get it going. We've got Neil in the box. He'll get things started off as we go to the sixth.
Ball one.
Off the plate with a fastball, and it's 1-0. One oh on the way. Swing and a hot shot. Oh, mercy, that one up the middle, just barely missed hitting him. Going to bring Rajah Davis to the plate.
This is what you're supposed to do when you're leading off an inning. Figure out a way to get on base any way you can. A hit's great, a walk's great, but just get on base because now you have the potential to score runs.
Lined out last time. And Martin's calling for the pitch.
Ball one.
Just missed with the fastball, 1-0. Take a look at this first pitch delivered and see how he's doing.
Pound the strike zone. Strike one, critical, and it's proving to play out in this one. He's retired 9 batters in this game when he's throwing a first pitch strike.
He's running.
Strike one!
He's out.
And he is out, trying to take second. Here's the pitch. 1-1 pitch, fastball, high, 2-1.
Ball three.
Fastball on the block. He doesn't get the call, though, and it's 3-1.
Well, hitters know those two-seam fastballs down on the way turn into ground ball out, so they lay off of it, but with two strikes, it's a pitch you have to swing at.
This is a swing hit in the air. That one's put away. Now two down.
Just an easy pop to second base. And as a pitcher, you'll take those all day long.
And Brantley's in the box. Now the first pitch.
Ball one.
Slider just misses, 1-0.
He tried to backdoor that pitch, but left it out and away.
Ball
1-0
two.
Pitch is a fastball high, 2-0. Slider just missed. He runs that to a 3-0 count.
Well, he's up in the count right here, 3-0. And you know he has the green light. As a hitter, you set middle in and try to get something in that zone to generate a run.
That ball misses. Four. Ball four. Now we're going to see if we'll get some motion on the base pass.
That's a close pitch, but he walks him in four pitches, and now he's got to go after the next guy.
That's going to bring Jason Kipnis up.
Well, two outs in the inning, you don't want to give a free pass. Make them earn it. As long as you keep it in the ballpark, it doesn't hurt you, but that walk can come back to haunt you.
First pitch on the way.
Strike one.
It's strike one. Can't make contact on the fastball. And with the walk surrendered as it was in the inning, you got to keep your composure now and not give in here.
Well, he certainly doesn't want to give up an extra base hit right now to allow that run to score, so the defense has got to be playing no double.
The pitch.
Foul.
This one's grounded near third. Foul. Here's a swing and a ground ball. Number 29 throws on to first in time to retire the side.
Gary really brought his A game for this one, executing all of his pitches. Great command and control. They haven't been able to muster any offense against him so far in this game.
Both teams still looking for that first run here. Leading off, Josh Donaldson. What's he doing to strike these hitters out? Take a look at how he's beginning.
You want your pitchers to be aggressive and go at the hitters and work ahead in the count. First pitch strikes the way to do it. Well, in this game, he's retired eight hitters after he's gone to an 0-1 count.
Swung on, that is hit. And in there, he's 2-for-3 today. That will bring up Jose Bautista.
Well, when you're the manager, nothing pleases you more than getting that leadoff hitter on base in the inning, because statistically it'll show you that they usually end up scoring.
0-for-2 thus far. Here's the first one.
Ball one!
It's taken for a ball. Bottom dropped out of that pitch on Jimenez.
Well, now he can follow that low fastball with an off-speed pitch, or he can come back with another fastball.
A 1-0 pitch.
Strike one.
Nasty split finger is in there. 1-1.
Well, this is an outstanding pitch. When you can throw a pitch with this kind of movement in sync away from the hitter, very effective.
Pitch on the way.
Strike two.
He watches the 1-1 pitch, takes a fastball, strike two. The 1-2 on its way.
Ball two.
Jose Bautista watches that one go by. A ball, evens the count.
Three.
Dugout wanted that one, but it's full now.
Now, big break on this curveball. He starts it in the strike zone, but it falls right out of the zone. Good eye by the hitter not to chase it.
Donaldson headed for the middle. Did not get out of the way. Those are scary. On to first, safe. Can't get the back end of that one. But a quick recovery that time gets the out. One down. Here's Edwin Encarnacion. And the elite home run leader in the top five last season. First pitch on the way here.
Ball one!
It's taken for a ball. Bottom dropped out of that pitch on Jimenez.
A big hitter in this big lineup, and a guy that counted on all year last year and really delivered. Gave them what they needed, Gary, and obviously looking for him to do it again.
And it's starting to head out towards the wall. He's thinking extra bases. Here's Bautista heading home. And he gets there all the way from first.
Well, as a manager, you love to see your guys hit doubles. It keeps your team out of double play situation, but it also has the ability to drive and run. And that's what he did here. He drove home that big run. He's feeling good.
We'll see Russell Martin now with a runner at second. And we've seen this offense building momentum. That momentum now has put them out in front. Wow.
Well, for a game that could go either way, we just saw an excellent example of clutch baseball.
And starts him out here. That one swung on, hit in the air to deep right center field. Two down. Encarnacion headed to third.
Tulowitzki is showing he likes to thrive in these big situations, Gary. You can tell by the look in his eyes, he wants to deliver again.
Lined out in his last at bat. Here's a swing and a ground ball. And Kipnis is able to find that one. And he throws on to first. That'll retire the side. Now we finally hear a whimper out of the offense. They put a run across. The Jays lead 1-0. And so Nick Swisher leading it off. Well, it's keeping up with the hit trends in this one. Let's take a look at the pitches that he's thrown on the mound that have been put in play.
That four-seam fastball of his, it's gotten hit twice. And at this point of the game, that may not mean a lot about that pitch.
You know, it's been touched a pair of times, but the way he's pitching, he looks to go deep in this game here. And no runs given up. Everything looks like it's working for him.
And it'll be Joaquin Benoit doing the pitching. He'll be relieving for the Blue Jays now. First pitch to Swisher. Good pitch as he's late on that one, 0-1. Last season, did not have any hits, one at bat off Joaquin Benoit.
Strike two.
And it's 0-2, Swisher, contact time.
Velocity and location are absolutely critical. That pitch was exactly where he wanted to throw it.
Benoit sets and throws.
Ball!
Can't get him to chase the fastball. Low, 1-2. Way inside. He's got to duck away from that one head high.
Well, he gets out of the way right there. If he hadn't been, he'd be headed to first base. Sometimes you have to take one for the team.
There's a swing and a ground ball. Picked up by Tulowitzki. One away. It's going to be Reynolds now. 0-2 lifetime against Joaquin Benoit. Starts him out here. Fastball misses away, 1-0.
There was a tale of two halves for Mark Reynolds in 2012. Started off the year slowly, but boy, he went on a tear in the last part of the season. He was a big reason why the O's pushed for a playoff spot.
Oh. That one's too high. Benoit tried upstairs. And for Mark Reynolds, really got hot at the end of August, the beginning of September, as Steve was talking about. He had a stretch there where he had 9 home runs and 9 games, John.
Yeah, and that was so much fun to watch for his team, I'm sure. But, you know, everything else about his season was very, very typical. He's going to hit a lot of home runs, and he's going to strike out a ton. And that's what you're going to get with Mark Reynolds. He's not going to change.
Strike one!
Now 3-1, Mark Reynolds with a hitter's count. Last year, 267 against the Blue Jays at Rogers Center. Now the 3-1 pitch. Hit in the dirt. Number 29. Out. Now it's two away. It's Lonnie Chisenhall at the plate. There are two down. Had a base hit his last time up. Here we go with the first pitch.
Strike one.
Starts him out with a changeup for a strike.
That changeup got away from him a little bit right there, but he did get a strike out of it.
Ball one.
And Lonnie Chisenhall will let that one go by to even up the count.
Well, that pitch right there, that changeup away, if a guy's looking for it, that's a great pitch to be able to hit the other way with some power.
It's fouled off.
Foul!
Big swing and a miss for Lonnie Chisenhall. Strike three, and he is gone. So they can't figure anything out. And through seven, they remain without a run. Still a shutout here in Toronto. We got the bottom three in the lineup due up. And here's B.J. Upton. He'll lead it off. He flew out his last time up. First pitch to him.
Ball!
It's taken for a ball. Bottom dropped out of that pitch on Jimenez.
Strike one!
And one swung and a miss by Upton. Strike evens it up. On the way.
Strike
swing and a miss on that fastball, and it's 1-2. One-two pitch coming.
Ball two.
And he leaves that one alone as B.J. Upton showing patience, evens the count. Gave him a fastball that time, but it's outside. 3-2.
Well, looking at this guy's pitch count, he's up over 80 pitches thus far. You wonder how long they're going to let him go.
And he takes that one and misses for ball four.
Well, if you're a batting coach, this is what you preach to your hitters. Be very disciplined at the plate. If he throws a strike, go ahead and let it rip. But if he doesn't, be patient with him, work your walks, make him throw a lot of pitches and get in that bullpen.
And they're behind in this ball game, and by the looks of things, they got a starter out there who's tired.
There's no question about it. I think they have to strongly consider making a move here as we see him before our eyes running out of gas.
Much too close for the runner's concern. He's back in there, though. There he goes for second.
Ball one!
And his throw, he is out. Great throw. He got him. Good pitch to throw on, Steve.
Well, he had the fastball, and it was set up in the right spot. He had a quick release to gun down the runner.
Ball two.
That's outside. Ball two.
Well, you can see what he's doing. He's just pulling that ball away from him, trying to overthrow it, and he can't seem to find the strike zone. He has to be able to rein that thing in right now.
A shot up the middle. That should be a base hit.
Well, you're going to have to keep a close eye on this guy at first base. Pay a lot of attention to him because you know he more than likely has the green light. He can go at any time.
Number 9 spot at the plate again. 0-2 thus far.
We've got the lead right now with speed on first base. You have to get him going. I think, Gary, keep the pressure on. Keep trying to tack on some run.
Look at his swisher to keep him near the bag. Drops down a bunt. Santana. And a good throw gets him. Two down.
Now, Gary, you know what? He didn't beat it out at first base, but he sacrificed himself to get the runner in scoring position.
Sometimes those things get lost in the course of a game, but not for the guys on the field. They realize the importance, especially if they get the run.
You know, we always celebrate the guy who drives in the run, but he's in scoring position because his teammate got a bunt there.
Here's the first one.
Strike one!
Scratch him up with a splitter for a strike.
It's important for that pitcher to get the first strike in there. Now he can go in a number of different directions.
Ball!
Tried to get him to go after the slider. 1-1. And Santana sets up his
ball
target.
Two.
That one's wide as Jimenez misses. Here's the 2-1. Line shot into center field. And Bradley grabs that one, and the sides are tied. Will they pick up a hit but leave a man at second and fail to score? Blue Jays 1, Cleveland nothing. New up 6-7-8 in the lineup. As Drubal Cabrera leading it off. He hit into a double play as last time.
Hi!
And we'll get to see Jason Grilli pitching. He'll be relieving for the Blue Jays now.
Well, going to the bullpen right here. That's his chess move. Let's see if it's checkmate.
Strike one.
And the pitch is taken for a strike by Cabrera. And that's a strike, as Drubal Cabrera is going to have to take a defensive stance here.
Ball
Fastball misses inside, and it's 1-2 now.
A front door two-seam fastball, trying to throw it inside, letting it tail back to the inside corner. Couldn't quite catch the corner.
You're out!
Big swing and a miss on a heater. Strike him out, one down.
We talked about a guy with full command of his pitches. Only four of them, but he located and executed them perfectly.
And as a result, this game stays close late.
Yeah, and you got to battle a little better than that. You just can't let a pitcher go in there and get four quick pitches and get a big strikeout. You got to battle better than that.
And Santana's in the box. Good season for Carlos Santana. Not quite the pop he had the year before. 19 home runs from the backstop. This at bat underway. 1-0 after that first pitch missed. In addition to that for Santana, 19 home runs and 70 runs and RBIs. And the big thing, Steve, with Santana, even while his average isn't that high, he finds a way to get on.
Well, 91 walks, fifth best in the American League. He's a guy that I think the power numbers are going to continue to grow. When hitters improve their walks and their power, they figured something out.
Lined right at the second baseman. Two away. We've got Neal in the box. 1-for-2 in the ballgame. He fouls that one off.
Foul!
Off the ground, played by Donaldson. He'll throw on to first, and that'll do it for this half inning. They're held in check yet again, scoreless through eight innings. No production yet from Cleveland. Two hole to get things started next. Turn to hit, looking for a little more success. Last time up, came away with a single off Jimenez.
On two occasions, he's tried to blow the four-seamer past him, and both times this guy...
Now a swing. That ball is hit well. Deep, going back. He heads all the way back to the warning track and gets the out. With this break in the action, let's take a look at the slugging percentage leaders from last year. Number one, Miguel Cabrera. Josh Hamilton is second. Third is Mike Trout. Adrian Beltre fourth. And it's Edwin Encarnacion, number five.
Boy, it's such an asset to an offense when you hit the ball out of the ballpark, and these guys are clearly so important to their teams. That ability to...
Bautista, the ground ball. And Cabrera picks it up. Yeah. And Bautista set down. And it's Edwin Encarnacion at the plate. Had an RBI double his last time. First pitch on the way.
Ball!
It's taken for a ball. Bottom dropped out of that pitch on Jimenez. Here's the pitch. 1-0 is a fastball that runs away, 2-0. This one has popped up to the left side out of play.
Foul!
Now the 2-1 pitch, hit up the middle. Oh, that'll move you on the mound. He just barely got out of the way.
Now a chance to see where Edwin Encarnacion ended up in the rankings last year. Third best in RBIs, fourth in home runs, and he was also ranked in the top five in on-base percentage, a real asset for his team to give his team a chance to score runs and have the run producers drive them in.
It's Russell Martin. And he'll start him out. Swings at that fastball and misses. 0-1.
It's always important to get that first strike in there late in the game in critical situations.
There's a swing and a smash. This one's towards Brantley. And there's the third out. No runs on a hit, and they'll strand it. And we'll see the Indians next. tension still in the air. This is only a one-run ball game. Leading it off, Raja Davis. And they're going to take a timeout here. They're going to have a little meeting at the mound.
Well, they're going to give them a little bit of time on the bullpen to try to get themselves ready in case they need to make a move.
Osuna will be their new pitcher. He comes in to close for Toronto.
Well, they've got themselves right where they want to be. Now it's up to the closer to come in and slam the door.
Going to make a defensive change here.
You know, they're losing a little bit in the defensive department with this change. It may be geared more toward offense. It's just odd to make this move right now.
On the ground to second. One away now. And Brantley's in the box. He swings on that 0-0 delivery, misses the fastball. Strike one.
Well, that's just one of those the pitcher says, here it comes, try to hit it. Fastball hitter, he wanted that pitch, he just didn't quite come up with the swing.
Ball!
Michael Brantley watches that one go by, that'll even up the count.
Well, a good pitch right there. He tried to get one in on his hands, but he just missed, though, in off the plate. Great pitch.
Up the middle, picked up by Tulowitzki. Yeah. That's the second out. Well, a chance here for Jason Kipnis with two down. And he bounced out his last time. Here's a fly ball. Could be it. That's going to be a wrap. Final out of the ball game.
Well, they treated their hometown crowd to a phenomenal pitching performance in this one. A big win on the shoulders of their pitchers.
So the honor is ready to be handed out. Our player of the game, a very deserving candidate. Marco Estrada, what a commanding presence in this one.
And he had everything working today in this game. Keeping the hitters off balance, that's the way you pitch. His off-speed pitches complementing his fastball. Everything was working. And that's why they got him for performances like this. And Gary, that's why we named him our player of the game.
And Steve, that ought to send these folks home happy.
Oh, no question about it. They get the win in a close game, a lot of excitement and enthusiasm, and ready for the next one.
This is Gary Thorne with John Cook and Steve Phillips. Hope you had a great time, as good as we did. Then you're all set. See you next time.